man. Oh, I got it.
How would you explain one of our typical breakout meetings to a person who has no understanding? I'm not sure how you do that.
When God shows up, He wants to move in the way He wants to move, not the way that we want Him to move. That's when things are alive.
I didn't believe in any of this, you know, flopping on the ground, throwing your hands up, and you're speaking in tongues. No way, it's all fake. Give them a padded cell, and they'll be okay.
During the peak of the outpouring, you know, we were having crowds of 7,000 to 10,000 almost daily.
I get more whacked up in the glory outside, like on the streets, than I do at the meetings. It's really amazing.
It's overwhelming. It's peaceful. It fills me with joy.
How does it feel?
Oh my gosh. God is so amazing.
That's like heaven on earth.
Through this revival, I know what it's like to feel Christ. I know what it's like when the power comes over you. I know what it's like when Jesus is right there in the room and right there standing next to you. And that alone has made me never, ever want to go back to what I was.
I had planned on committing suicide. The night that I got healed, I literally had the gun on me. And I was ready to commit suicide. The God at the very door of what I was going to walk into stood at the door and fought for me.
I came here 17 days ago, and 12 days ago, my pancreatic cancer has caused me pain that was terminal, gave me 1 to 3 months to live. I'm now on my second month of that death sentence. I've got more energy now. The noticeable lumps in my side are gone. The pain is gone for 12 days now. So, and I didn't believe.
People want real. They want real. They don't care if real is ugly. They don't care if real is raw. They don't care if real is, you know, something that is so out of the ordinary. They just want real.
Todd's used to doing big campaigns, you know, crusades and all in Africa with large audiences and extraordinary miracles taking place. It just seemed easy in Africa. All of a sudden, extraordinary miracles started breaking out on a level they'd never seen in America. You know, it was just people desperate for God.
There's been thousands and thousands of people that have been healed, miraculously healed. And so it's a move of God. It's not man trying to contain it or control it.
I got in trouble with the law quite a few times. I never went to jail, but I should have gone to jail several times. And here I am. I didn't deserve to be here.
It's just so good to see so many people taking a stand.
That's the King's Castle. That's the backdrop for the event.
So if you could see sort of the wild outgoings at our place as one big party that God wants to be a part of. Only this kind of party tries to help people's lives change. Maybe then you'll begin to grasp some of what's going on.
Healings like I've never seen in my life. People who are completely deaf from birth, 100% can hear.
And so I came out that night on the microphone in front of all the people here. It is 7 o'clock. They've come to the 4-day conference, no revival. Nobody has a clue what we're talking about in the background. And I just said these words. I said, what if tonight could be the night? That's all I said.